सर्वेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यवर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis. Srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanedars, sitting with us through Nityananda TV. Sadhana TV and two-way video conferencing. Having Naina Diksha, the city is sitting with us, having Naina Diksha, Scottsdale, Arizona, Port Washington, New York, Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, Jnaneshwar, Nepal, High Point, North Carolina, Hong Kong, Sirgadi, Belgium, Vishveshwarananda, New York, High Point, North Carolina, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, Tallahassee, Florida, Nityananda University, Paris, Bangalore, North, Hong Kong, Sirgadi, Oman, Sivagangai, Vadodara, and Dubai, Vaidyanatham, Simi Valley, California, Tiruvanmiyur, Chennai, Charlotte, Sri Sailam, Penang, Tiruparangundram, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Tiruvanmiyur, Chennai, Seattle, Chidambaram, Simi Valley, California, San Jose, Madurai, Toronto, Kailasam, Singapore, Singapuram, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Tiruvanmiyur, Chennai, and Houston, Kalahastie, Surrey, Canada, Kuala Lumpur, Palani, Ohio, Prayag, Mukta, Seattle. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Winston Salem, North Carolina, and Kathmandu, Nepal. I can see you also. Blessings. I wanted to continue to expand on the subject which I was expanding yesterday, the science of creating space. This science is the most powerful, most sacred, and what Krishna calls in the 9th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Raja Vidya Raja Guhya Yoga, means the royal knowledge, royal secret. The science needs so much of completion. If you just see the morning, today morning, before the satsang starting, I asked some of our swamis to do bhajan. This is going on for last 1 week. Still they are not even able to come to a visualization how they should present themselves. We may think, just by the way of sitting, what is there, why Swamiji should take this so seriously? There are some stupid fellows thinking like that. Why is Swamiji so serious about every small point? Understand, authenticity aligns even the way you breathe, not just the way you sit on what you sit, not just your asana, the way you sit, it aligns even your breathing, your thinking. Sanya starts with your ability to stand for your authenticity. if you have to do puja, your whole dress, the jewelry you are wearing, the marks you are wearing, your body language, the way your voice, everything has to change. If you are sitting and teaching, the way you sit, on which you sit, your asana, your body language, your words, everything has to change. That is what is authenticity. That is what is egolessness. Suddenly they asked me to sing. How can I? What do I know? Only today morning they called me. No, that is what I call ego. Understand, even in your life, you go on disrespecting the space you need to hold. When you are sitting in your office, if you do not know the loss of the people who are sitting around you and your team, and if you try to apply the loss of the house, the way you deal people in the house, if you try to use the same law with your team, without bringing that completion, please understand, if you bring completion, your team, family, both will have same level of intense love, connection, Advaita state with you. But if you don't bring completion, the law of team is different, law of family is different. That is why the fellows who are having affairs in the office will never be successful in their career. Having affair in the office is suicide. Your career suicide. Whatever may be the profession you have taken up, if you have a fire in the office, your whole career will die, because you will not have the right space for the office in office. First of all, understand the space you have inside you is like an inner organ. Just like your kidney, heart, intestine, your physical organs, the space you carry is an inner organ. If you are constantly carrying a depressed space or the impossible space, non-enthusiastic space, non-uncommittal space, non-committal space, so much of arrogance and impossibility. I can say the modern day kids are cursed with this impossibility, because the bringing up of the urban lifestyle itself is impossibility. I have seen in my villages, one man will do electricity, plumbing, construction. Anything you ask, he will do it. I have seen like that, at least 100 people in villages. He will be the Nadaswaram. And don't think like a very cheap, low-level quality of music he will do. He will be the village barber. I have seen. Those people only I have seen so egoless. The powerful space they will be holding, they may not have created wealth using that space, but I can tell you they have created life for themselves having that space. urban bringing up first destroys your belief the possible. The moment the possible is destroyed, every small thing is complicated. No one wants to look at the other side. Even a small thing you are brought up by constantly feeding impossible, 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 abusing the space you need to carry. Understand, whether you are handling money in your life, business, or knowledge in your life, learning or teaching, or power in your life, means having somebody under you or being under somebody, either a leader or follower. That is handling power. Handling knowledge means either a student or teacher. Handling wealth, either earning or sharing. Whatever you may think you are doing, please listen. Whether you handle life, whether you handle wealth, whether you handle power, if you don't know to create the space and melt down, your ego is enough to kill you. Your ego is enough to kill you. Anything which you are handling with your ego, without creating a space, you already internally aborted the possibility. Ego and creation of the space, these two are completely opposite. Ego means the frozen. Means the stool which has not come out of your body. Creating a space means the ability to have, ability to visualize and hold anything you want to create. Your ability to create and hold anything you want listen. Ego is like a frozen, space is like a pure vastness, living vastness, living emptiness is space. The word emptiness, always you think it is dead. Living emptiness is space. Living emptiness is space. Ability to create the living emptiness as and when you want, not being affected by the ego, is what we call in Sanskrit Chitta Shuddhi. In the traditional Vedanta, the Chitta Shuddhi is the life. anything can be done for chitta shuddhi. Means complete inner space, the space which has achieved complete completion is sutta chitta. Tremendous authenticity which is required for life. Understand? Again and again I want to tell you, your impossibilities make life so difficult, look like life is so difficult. Even by the time you do a small thing, you are tired. It's like without releasing the handbrake, you are driving the car. With the handbrake on, if you drive the car, how it will be? That's exactly with impossibility, you are pushing your life. See, when you are pushing your life, just like the car being driven with the handbrake on, you will live with minimal things. Life only in a minimal level. Because you always think, oh, I am new to this. Or, I am not going to be doing this forever. Either I am new to this, or I am not going to be doing this forever. If you are asked to do puja, oh, today only I have started. Or, you are with the thinking, anyhow in 1 week they will change. I am not going to be doing this. Constantly approaching life with instability. Instead, oh, only today I got a chance. Within a week they may remove me, but in this 1 week let me do it authentically and learn and do it. Just in this few line, I'll define the science of creating a space. Complete with the constant non-committal attitude with life. Complete with the constant non-trusting attitude with the life. Decide to wear life. If the life is a pond, get into it. Again and again and again, verifying whether you are thinking the direction in which your energy is flowing, is this authentic? Means, is this in tune with your inner image? The best inner image you want to have. Is the thinking going on inside you now? Is it supporting the best inner image you want to have? Is it supporting the best outer image you want to have? Is it supporting the other's image you want to have? Is it supporting the life image you want to have? Again and again and again, see the way you are thinking now. Always try to come back and see the way you are thinking now, is it in alignment with the best inner image you want to have, best outer image you want to have, best others image you want to have, and best life image you want to have? This is what is thinking authenticity, making yourself authentic. Making yourself authentic. Thinking authenticity. Making yourself authentic. Think whether your thinking is going in the direction of your authenticity. Think whether your thinking is going in the direction of authenticity. See continuously whether your thinking is going towards your best inner image, best outer image, best others image, best life image. And align your thinking towards that. That's all is the essence of today's satsang. This is what is the essence of creating the space. Essence of science of creating space.
I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.